Radio 108 every morning at 9 a.m., or Saturday mornings at 9 a.m., and I alternate with Sarah Asher, so I hope you'll see you in class. And till then, today I'd like to share with you some hip opening, but also hip strengthening postures to improve your posture in general and your poses, all your asana. And I have Teresa, who is the founding owner of the studio, here to demonstrate the poses for me. So I'll have you stand right at the top of your mat, Teresa. Thank you. And then we'll stand in Tadasana. So her feet will be rooted down parallel to one another. Feet can be close together or apart. Just feel the sense of what is connected to the earth. And from that foundation, you can begin to inhale and reach just the chest upward. And on the exhale, feel your fingers tips pulling down like little weights, pulling you downward, the shoulders pulling down to away from the ears. And then we'll begin to inhale and bring the palms to press right in front of your heart. We'll take a little reach up, so rooting down through your feet, reaching your palms up overhead. Just take a full stretch of your body each direction. And on the exhale, we'll float the palms wide as you fold over your knee, over your legs in a Uttanasana, keeping a little micro bend behind the knees. And on an inhale, you can use the blocks under your hands here if touching the floor. For most people, Teresa's fine here, but for most people, touching the floor is not an option, especially not right away in practice. So it's always fine to use the blocks to raise the floor up to the height that you need or to place the hands on the shins or the thighs. So from an inhale, I'll have you bend your knees and we'll step your right foot back behind you onto the ball of your foot, coming into a posture that we call low lunge. By pressing the whole hand into the block, she's lifting the heart upward and bringing her spine all the way from the top of her neck down through the tailbone into one long, nice line. And by rooting down through both feet, and I think about the front foot first, because the toes tend to take a lot of pressure here. We're trying anything we can to not use the muscles that we're trying to use, which are those in the legs. So we'll press down through the heel and relax the toes downward so they're soft and not tightened or clenched. And then from here, Teresa may be able to lift her back leg a little higher to activate those muscles around the hips and through the whole hamstring. And we can always reach the heel back a little more just to create length from the crown of your head all the way through your heel. Very nice. And then on an exhale, when that comes round for you, so Teresa is breathing throughout all these postures. I haven't been referring to that, but it's a very important aspect of yoga asana. Deep, full breaths in. And on your next exhale, you can begin to lower your knee down to the mat. You can cushion the knee with a blanket. Is your knee comfortable here, Teresa? Do you need a blanket?
No.
Okay, so for many people, a blanket's a useful tool. And then we'll take a pose called Anjaneyasana from here. So many variations. One way to keep your hands straight down on the blocks. And once you settle your feet, and you may want to bring your left foot a little more left for balance. So that's always fine to move your block out a little ways as Teresa's doing and just wiggle the foot to the left. So that gives you room to breathe into the belly, filling up with breath. It gives you room for your chest, for your arm to hug in next to your thigh for support and to keep that knee in alignment right over the ankle. And then if you feel like adding on, you can bring the fingers to the tops of your thigh and either interlace them onto the thigh so you have something to just balance on, to be able to give that also the support to lift up the shoulders as Teresa's doing here. And if you want to take it one step further, always it's possible to change these poses to meet your needs. But the expression of Anjaneyasana, this full extended armed lunge, is another variation. But Teresa has a very nice curve in her back, so there's no pressure, no crunching in the low back, and it's more about an arch through the upper back. And then when you're ready on an inhale, Teresa, you can take it all the way back to the ground, lowering the hands down to your blocks. And then on an inhale, lifting your kneecap, curling the toes under, lift your knee away from the mat. And then placing your right hand on the inside of your left foot onto the block or on the mat, either way. And if you want to take a little twist to the left, you'll reach on an exhale, the arm overhead or just to your hip, whichever version you'd like. And we'll take that on an inhale, the arm all the way back down to frame your foot. And when you're ready, she's enjoying some breath first. I thought I kept her here too long, but I think she's very comfortable in low lunge. It can become a good pose for you, a nice release of tension in the hips, and it definitely strengthens your muscles through the legs and releases the hamstrings, so it can allow you to stand up more upright. So inhaling and framing your foot whenever you're ready. And I'll have Teresa take this straight back to downward facing dog, pressing your hands into the mat and drawing the foot back for a nice release of the pose after you've taken quite a while in low lunge. And I'll give her a little release of the back. Good. Beautiful. So thank you very much. I hope we'll see you in class sometime.